Here there's an ishkal. Ishkal means there is a matter that will puzzle an individual, which is that the author rahimahullah, it's as though, or it seems that what he has done is, he has ascribed the prohibition to a'yan and dhawat. He brings it back to the private parts. He brings the halal and the haram back to the nafs. He brings the halal and the haram back to the mal. He brings that back to halal and the haram to dhawat and a'yan, which the Sharia isn't the case. That isn't the case. What is well known according to the Usuliyin is what? That the ahkam al-taklifi, which we took, in Usul al-Waraqat, which is the five types of ahkam al-taklifi. Wajib, haram, makruh, mubah, and mandub or mustahab. Those five, they are what? They are ahkam al-taklifi. They are jurisprudent rulings in which a person has to come with by one of these five forms. So usul al-fiqh, they say ahkam al-taklifi, those five types, they cannot be ascribed to things. They can't. Whereas ahkam al-wad'iyah, they are ascribed back to things. They are ascribed back to dawat. So how do we get out of this? The scholars, they have two methodologies in how they reply back to this point. Or this, if this ishkal is brought forward, there's two ways to answer it. There's two manhaj, there's two tariqa to take. The first one is that we bring it back to the custom and the urf, which is al-aslu, the asal fil abda'i. Abda'i means what? The urf is what? A wat'ul abda'i, intimacy with the private parts. So we bring the وَالْأَصْلُ فِي اللُّحُمِ يَعْنِي فِي أَكْلِهَا, eating it. So we don't bring it back to the thing, we bring it back to the action that's been done. Because the taklif is what? فِعْلُ الْمُكَلَّفِ, the action of the mukallaf who's doing it. وَالْأَصْلُ فِي الْأَنْفُسِ يَعْنِي فِي سَفْكِهَا, in spilling it. The amwal, we say فِي أَخْذِهَا, in taking it. We always bring it back to the action. That's the first manhaj. That's the first path. Na'am. And that's based upon the urf and the custom. The second path is that we anna al-hukma yutlaq ala jami'il al-af'al al-munasaba. We don't restrict it to the custom, but we bring it back to any action in which it can fall under. So for example, all of those that we've mentioned, any one of them, any actions that are done within them, that it's haram. And that's the two methodologies that the scholars, they take. Now, والأصل, the author then says, وَالْأَصْلُ فِي عَادَاتِنَا الْإِبَاحَةِ حَتَّى يَجِي أَصَارِفُ الْإِبَاحَةِ. The author here, رحمه الله, he says, وَالْأَصْلُ, the original essence, فِي عَادَاتِنَا, our customs, is what? الإباحة, is permissible. حَتَّى, until يَجِي أَصَارِفُ الْإِبَاحَةِ, unless there comes what? Something that diverts it from its permissibility. The original custom is that things are permissible for you to do unless there comes an evidence and removes it from the permissibility. And this qa'ida, it falls under mundarijatun tahta qa'idati al-madhkuri anifan, the qa'ida we previously mentioned, which is al-yaqinu la yuzalu bishak, al-yaqinu la yazulu bishak. It falls under that qa'ida. The adat, what does it mean here? Wal muradu bil adati, the intent that's meant by the word ada, it means ما لا يتقرب به الإنسان. It is that which the servant doesn't get close to. ويتعبد به, and he doesn't worship Allah by doing it. He's not doing this action to get closer to Allah, or he's not doing this to worship Allah. إباحة, he is meant by والأصل في عادات الإباحة. إباحة means الإذن في في فعل الشيء وفي تركه. That they have, you have a permission in doing this action or in leaving it. We elaborated on the issue of ibaha and the types that it breaks into when we were studying what? Al-waraqat. We spoke about it there. What shows this qa'ida? that the asal in the adat, that is ibaha, that is permissible, the customs, is many texts from the Shari'ah. قَوْلُهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ Allah's statement, هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا Allah is the one who created for you everything that is on this earth. And those are many texts. Many, many other texts also prove that. So as I said, the asal of the qa'ida, the asal of the adat is what? أَنَّهَا مُبَاحَ That it's what? It's mubah. لَيْسَتْ بِوَاجِبَةً وَلَيْسَتْ مُحَرَّمَةً It's not wajib and it's not haram. The asal of the customs. What are the things? Because the author said, look, وَالْأَصْلُ فِي عَادَاتِنَا الْإِبَاحَ حَتَّى يَجِيءَ صَارِفُ الْإِبَاحَةِ What does he mean by the sarif? The sarif are two types. صارف قد يكون بدليل طلب الفعل وقد يكون بدليل يطلب ترك الفعل. The sarif of something, the sarif of ibaha is the other four types. That is a sarif. Anything that makes it a wajib, anything that makes it an amr, a nahi, sorry, a prohibition. So amr, which is wajib, anything that makes it wajib, anything that makes it haram, anything that makes it makruh, and anything that makes it a sunnah. All four of those left are sarif, they diverted. So remember we said talabul fi'l wa talabu وَدَلَبُوا tark, anything that becomes دَلَبُوا الْفِعْلُ وَطَلَبُوا tark, and two comes out of each other. We took that in usulul fiqh, two come out of each other. طَلَبُوا الْفِعْلِ, how many come out of it? Al-wajib and al-mandub. طَلَبُوا tark, comes out under it, how many? Two. Haram, التحريم, and al-karaha. Those four are sawarif. They divert it from ibaha. Something when it's mubah, and I say, this is mubah, until a sarif diverts it from it. The sarif that comes, it can divert it by making it one of those four. By making it what? By when it is four. The evidences that show is Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in the Qur'an, قُلْ مَنْ حَرَّمَ زِينَةَ اللَّهِ الَّتِي أَخْرَجَ لِعِبَادِي وَالطَّيِّبَاتِ مِنَ الرِّزْقِ قُلْ هِيَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا خَالِصَةً يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ Allah says, who is the one that makes the beauty which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He has brought for His creation, and the beautiful, the طيبات, the good things from provision. Who's the one who makes it haram? You can't. Unless there's an evidence for it. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَقَدْ فَصَّلَ لَكُمْ مَا حَرَّمَ عَلَيْكُمْ إِلَّا مَضْضُرْتُمْ إِلَيْهِ Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He has detailed for us what's haram. So whatever we don't find that Allah said is haram, the asal is for His permissibility. The Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam, pay attention to this hadith. Bukhari didn't narrate this hadith because it doesn't fulfill his conditions. Like Imam Muslim al-Nasa'i narrated it. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ مِنْ أَعْظَمِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ جُرْمًا The people who have the greatest crime, who are what? مَنْ سَأَلَ عَنْ شَيْءٍ A person who, a matter he's asked about, لَمْ يُحَرَّمْ And it wasn't made haram, فَحُرِّمَ And it then became haram, مِنْ أَجْلِ مَسْأَلَتِ Because of his asking. Also the Prophet said, دَرُونِي مَا تَرَكْتُكُمْ Leave what I have left for you. Don't ask about what I haven't spoken about. Don't speak about it. Here a question arises. The question is, these texts that you guys have brought, all of them, they indicate that the haram is lifted. That what? The tahrib, every ayat you brought. قُلْ مَنْ حَرَّمَ Who's the one who made haram? So it's lifting the haram. The ayah, وَقَدْ فَصَّلَ لَكُمْ مَا حَرَّمَ عَلَيْكُمْ إِلَّا مَا اضْطُرِرْتُمْ إِلَيْهِ إِنَّ مِنْ أَعْظَمِ النَّاسِ جُرْمًا مَنْ سَأَلَ عَنْ شَيْءٍ لَمْ يُحَرِّمْ فَحُرِّمَ مِنْ أَجْلِ مَسْأَلَتِي All of them are talking about lifting the prohibitions. And if the prohibition is lifted, it doesn't always fall to ibaha. It doesn't always fall to ibaha. It can also fall into wujub, wajib. So where have you guys got from? Because nafyu tahrim, they say, ulama, nafyu tahrim mutaraddidun bayna al-wujubi wal-ibaha. Something that haram is stripping from it. It's between it becoming what? Mubah. And it becoming wajib. Naam. Good. The answer inshallah ta'ala is إِنَّ الْإِجَابَ مُتَضَمِّنٌ لِلْتَحْرِيمِ تَرْكِ وَالضِّدِ That the wajib what consists in the wajib is what? Every wajib, what consists in it is that this something is, it's the opposite is haram. Every wajib, that is present, the opposite is it, that's haram. So example, if we say, this is wajib, we've affirmed automatically what? Within it, we affirmed it, that there's a haram, which is opposite. But the ibaha, no. It doesn't fall like that. So what? It's not the case. So automatically, the wajib is already present. It doesn't need to be said. So the only meaning that it can take is ibaha. So the only thing that we can take from that is that the ibaha is what's intended. Good. For example, لا يقال بوجوب صلاة سادسة ولا بوجوب صيام شهر آخر غير رمضان وغيرهما من الواجبات لعدم ورود الدليل بالإجاب والأصل الإباحة كما سبقت الإشارة إليه. For example, we don't say that it's obligatory. We don't say it's obligatory. Huh? That there's a fifth prayer. Unless there comes an evidence. And we can't say that there's a month which is wajib for the people to fast other than Ramadan, unless there's evidence. We can't do that. But the asal is what? Because we've negated wajib, the asal automatically, it can be haram or it can be what? Ibaha. But automatically it's going to fall into what? Al-ibaha. If a person wants to fast any other month fully, he can do it. It's up to him. He's permitted to do so. The author then said, حَتَّى يَجِيءَ صَارِفُ الْإِبَاحَ. Until it comes, a thing that diverts it from its ibaha. And I've elaborated on that. Na'am. I just want to mention one thing before I move on from the other, to the other qa'ida, which is, a lot of people, they rely on this qa'ida without having to do any research. And this qa'ida, لا يعمل بهذه القاعدة, this qa'ida is not implemented. حتى يبحث المجتهد, until the mujtahid, who is doing the ijtihad, he has researched into the text and the evidences which are out there. Is there any sarif in this issue? Is there any what? Sarif, he has to observe and look for it. Is it present or is it not? Huh? Na'am. Some scholars, they argue, no. He doesn't have to. He doesn't have to because they said that غَلَبَةُ الظَّنْ is enough. غَلَبَةُ الظَّنِّ is enough. Some of the scholars, they said غَلَبَةُ الظَّنْ suffices it. Because he's basing it on that which it's most likely. And we took the evidence for غَلَبَةُ الظَّنِّ that it's we use it here. So the person is allowed to use this opposite to the view that says that this is the incorrect view in this matter. But the people who can implement this qa'idah are the mujtahideen. As for the ammi, the general mass, his job is to do what? هذا مقلد. His point is الجواب عن عليه سؤال العلماء. He asked the scholars. As Allah said, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask those who know if you don't know. وَلَيْسَ مَشْرُوعًا مِنَ الْأُمُورِ غَيْرُ الَّذِي فِي شَرْعِنَا مَذْكُورِ. The author here is talking about that the qa'idah, this qa'idah, this bait, it talks about the qa'idah, which is the ibadat, the asl of it is haram. Unless there comes an evidence that makes it permissible. Al-aslu fil ibadat at-tahrim. The asl of any ibadah, it is haram. Anybody who wants to do an ibadah, he has to bring evidence for this ibadah. He has to bring evidence for it. You can't worship Allah tabarak wa ta'ala with any ibadah. Illa idha warada dalilu min ash-shari'i bi kawni tilka al-ibadati mashru'a. Unless there comes, you bring evidence forward, and you say, قال الله, قال الرسول, you bring it. Based on the understanding of the Salaf of this Ummah. So a person cannot just invent a new ibadah. in which he wants to get closer to Allah with it. And if a person does it, it becomes what? An innovation. What is it a haram from? As I said, every ibadah, it is haram unless evidence is brought for it. Pay attention. Number one, it is haram. The asal of the ibadat being tahrim is number one. In original essence of initiating is haram. So if a person just makes up an ibadah, the fact that he what? He initiated an ibadah, the ibadah is haram. La yajuz. Good. The second one is, the ibadah is there. Are you with me? The ibadah is there. But you initiate, you don't bring a new ibadah, but you initiate a characteristics for it. You do a dhikr in a particular form. The dhikr is already original in the kitab and the sunnah. To remember Allah tabarak wa ta'ala orders us in the Qur'an and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions it in the hadith. But the person, he makes a description for it, a way. Allah, 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 he says that. He makes this sifa, this form, which is not found in the text. This becomes a what? It becomes a bid'ah. It becomes what? Haram. La yajuz. Also, or the person, something that the Sharia unrestricted, just allowed it. For example, the Sharia permitted for you to do dhikr. And you say, I'm only going to do the dhikr. أخصصها في الزمان. I'm specifically going to do it in one particular time. Are you with me? Like the Sharia said to you what? Show love to your mom. And show love to your parents. And you say, I'll only do it on one day of the year. La yajuz bid'ah. So you're trying to get closer to Allah with it. Or I'm only going to show my mom love on a Sunday. Naam. Or he says, I'm only going to show my mom love when we go back to our country. Anything which in the Sharia, it's permissible. But the person, he specifies it in a place or a time. The next one is, or any other than that. All of those. كل هذا من البدعة المحرمة. All of those are innovation in the Sharia. And there is no legislation for it. Then it becomes haram. Where's the evidence for that? Allah تبارك وتعالى said in the Quran, قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. Do you claim to love Allah? Are you true about the love of Allah? Then follow the messenger. The asal is ittiba. The asal is ittiba. The asal is not ibtida' to innovate. The asal is what? Ittiba' to follow. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala also said, وَاتَّبِعُوهُ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ. Follow him so you can find guidance. Allah also said, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Also the Messenger, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala also said, أَمْ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاءَ شَرَعُوا لَهُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا لَمْ يَأْذَنْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. Good. Also the hadith of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, Bukhari and Muslim both narrated, مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي أَمْرِنَا هَذَا مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ فَهُوَ رَدَّ. وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ another wording, مَنْ عَمِلَ عَمَلَ لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرُنَا فَهُوَ رَدَّ. Also the hadith, which Abu Dawood Tirmidhi narrated that the Prophet said, وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحْدَثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. If that is the case, we've understood that. This qa'idah is a very important qa'idah. This qa'idah protects the sharia. From what? من التحريف والتبديل. Distortion. Tampering with the sharia. If we said that every single person can initiate a ibadah he likes, whenever he feels like it's a good thing, then this will become a means to what? To change, to alter the religion. You see? And it's also a means to describe the sharia as a sharia, a legislation which is incomplete. It's incomplete religion. And that it requires us to add things to it for it to be complete. And then it's a means to basically slander the messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. The final messenger who Allah sent. That he didn't fulfill his responsibility. Or that he did, alayhi salatu wasalam, but this individual knows better than the messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. He's always insulting the Prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam. The bid'ah, the innovation that occur from the people are two types. And they're both haram. There are two types like him. Bid'ah which occur in the people's actions. It's bid'ah. It's an action that the person does. It's not an aqidah issue. It's just an action which he's doing. An example would be like that. The man by the name of, his name was Abu Israel, he was called. His name was Abu Israel. Bukhari narrated it. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he saw a man standing in the sun. The Prophet asked about this man, he said, why is he standing in the sun? They said, that, Ya Rasulullah, that man you see, his name is Abu Israel. He made an oath to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala that he's going to stand in the sun and that he's not going to sit and that he's not going to look for a shade and that he's going to be fasting. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, Muruhu, go and order him. أَنْ يَقْعُدَ وَيَسْتَظِلَّ وَأَنْ يَتِمَّ صَوْمَهُ. Order him to sit down, to look for a shade, but let him carry on his fasting. Pay attention. The fasting is legislated, that's why. He's allowed to carry that on. But trying to get closer to Allah by doing an innovation, by doing what? By standing in the sun. Yeah? Or to say, I'm going to get closer to Allah by standing up all day. I'm going to stand all day. Bid'ah. But this is bid'ah amali. It's an innovation. It's haram. لا يجوز. It's a bid'ah ضلاله. The second type is the bid'ah which falls in the person's aqidah. If it's a bid'ah which is aqadi, the person falls into aqidah issue, like that which the Jahmiyyah and the Mu'tazila and the Khawarij and the Sha'ira and the deviated sects all fell into. Which is to what? They came with an innovation in terms of their belief system. They started to believe in this issue. Naam. Here I have to mention an issue that I touched on slightly before, but I'm going to elaborate on it a bit more, which is the action which isn't legislated. An action which a person does which isn't legislated, in that which he adds to it, onto an action which is originally permissible. So for example, the salat to dhuhr, is it originally permissible? Na'am. It's allowed. But the person comes and he adds an additional rak'ah to it. Now the additional rak'ah isn't permissible. Are you with me? But the salah, is it permissible, the four rak'ah that he prayed? Pay attention now. This is a qa'idah you need to know. Every action a person adds to something that is originally permissible. Are you with me? A person does an action on top of something that is originally allowed. Sometimes what happens is that action, that's the first time, that additional thing which you've added onto something, what does it do? فَحِينَئِذٍ تُبْطِلُهُ. It nullifies the original essence of the whole salah. The whole salah is nullified. All of your salah is batil. You paid four rak'ah and then you added a fifth one to it. The whole five rak'ah, all of your five is gone. Why? Because the fifth one that you have done is added and it's with the previous four. They are all connected. This is called ziyada muttasila. It's a additional which is attached. So that all of them goes batil. The second type is ziyada which is munfasila. It's detached, it's not attached to it. And it doesn't go back to the original fi'il and it doesn't nullify it. Mithal, a person, man tawadda arba'a rak'atin. Man tawadda, a person who does wudu four times. He's meant to do how many times? Four, three times. Or he's allowed to do two times, or he's allowed to do once. So he can, the maximum he can do is how many? Three. What does he do? He does four. فَالْمَرَّةِ الرَّابِعَةِ بِدْعَةٌ. The fourth one he added to it, we'll say it's an innovation. لَكِ لَا تَعُودُ عَلَى الْغَسَلَاتِ الثَّلَاثَةِ بِالْإِبْطَالِ. But it doesn't go back to the previous three and it doesn't nullify it. Why? Because it's detached from it. Some of the ulama, they use this line of the Shaykh, وَلَيْسَ مَشْرُوعًا مِنَ الْأُمُورِ غَيْرَ الَّذِي فِي شَرْعِنَا غَيْرُ الَّذِي فِي شَرْعِنَا مَذْكُورٌ. Some scholars, they said this right now, the Shaykh means something else by it. That the Shaykh means that our Sharia, it's not a proof for us. That the Shaykh here, some scholars, they said that أَنَّ الْمُرَادَ بِهِ عَدَمُ حُجِّيَةُ الشَّرَائِعَ السَّابِقَةَ. That the previous legislations are not a proof for us. We don't use them, we can't implement them. Now we have to talk about the issue of وَالشَّرْعُ مَنْ قَبْلَنَا. The legislation of the previous nations, how do we deal with it? It's of two types. The previous شَرَائِع, the previous legislations, they are of two types. الأول, the first one. The first one. مَا نُقِلَ بِوَاسِطَةِ الْأُمَمِ السَّابِقَةِ. The previous nations, what they were legislated, It's two ways. The first one is that which has been transmitted to us. It's been what? It has been transmitted to us by the nations themselves. They transmitted it to us. They telling us about their own religion. فَهَذَا لَا يُحْتَجُّ بِهِ This one we don't use as a proof. Why? لِعَدَّمِ الثِّقَّةِ بِذَلِكَ النَّقَلِ Because they're not reliable in their transmission. They are not reliable in their transmission. So we don't take it from them. They're the ones who transmitted it to us. We don't take it from them. The second one is مَا نُقِيلَ فِي الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ That which the Kitab and the Sunnah we find in it. That is that was their legislation. The Qur'an and Sunnah mention it. Good. Good. The scholars, they divide that one into three. The second type, they divide it into three categories that come under it. One, ما أقره شرعنا. That which our Sharia permitted. It legislated it with them. كالصيام like fasting. Allah said in the Qur'an, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ The fasting was legislated for them, and it's also legislated for us. We have to do. Number two, ما نسقه شرعنا. Our Sharia abrogated this issue. كالتحريم الغنائم. Like the issue of the prohibition of booty. The previous nations, they were not allowed to take the booties. They would, whenever they finished a battle, they would take their spoils of war and they will place it in the middle of the battlefield. A fire will come from the sky and it will take everything. Khalas. They were not allowed to take anything. And if anyone took something and he done gulul, I stole something from it, the fire won't come. And everyone say, hey, who took it? Fear Allah, bring it wherever you take it. You see? Our legislation, what did he do? It made that haram. Now we take it. And it made a what do you call it? It made for it a taqsimat, a categorization, a way it's going to be distributed. Number three. So that second one, فَهَذَا لَيْسَ شَرْعًا لَنَا It's not legislation for us. It's not a legislation for us. The third one is مَا لَمْ يَكُمْ مِنَ الصِّنْفَيْنِ السَّابِقَيْنِ That which is not from the previous two. Our Sharia did not affirm it, and it didn't allow it. And our Sharia also did not what? It didn't abrogate it. It didn't abrogate it. It didn't abrogate it. What is the issue here? وَهَذَا مَحَلُّ خِلَافِ بَيْنَ الْأُصُولِيِّينَ This is where the big battle took place. What should we do here? مَا أَقَرَّهُ شَرْعُنَا Al-Sharia did not affirm it. And also what? مَا نَسَقَهُ شَرْعُنَا Our Sharia didn't what? وَالْأَظْهَرُ أَنَّهُ حُجَّةٌ The strongest it seems like it is that it's a proof. It's a proof. وسائل الأمور كالمقاصد وحكم بهذا الحكم للزوائد. The author now, رحمه الله تعالى, he moves on to the 24th line. He says, he talks about وسائل and مقاصد. What is a وسائل? وسائل الأمور means الطرق المفضية إلى المقاصد. وسائل الأمور means what? It is that the path that would lead you to the objective and the aims that you're looking for. Maqasid is what? It's the objectives, it's the ghayat. It is the objective you're looking for. What is zawa'id? Zawa'id is that which completes the action. Are you with me? It's the thing that completes the action. So we have three here right now that the Sheikh mentioned. He mentioned wasa'il, he mentioned maqasid, and he mentioned zawa'id. Wasa'il is the means, Maqasid is the objective in which a person wants, and the zawa'id is what completes it. As they say, the cherry on the cake. Is that extra point? Pay attention now. This issue needs to be very well understood. وَالْوَسَائِلْ إِنْ كَانَ لَهَا حُكْمٌ مُسْتَقِلٌ If the wasa'il, the means, has its own ruling, if the means, has its own ruling. For example, it's wajib or it's haram. Then فَإِنَّا تَأْخُذُ حُكْمَهَا الْأَصْلِ It takes its original ruling, which the Sharia placed for it. For example, أَنْ يُتَوَسَّلَ الْإِنسَانُ لِوَطْءِ الْأَجْنَبِيَّةِ بِعَقْدِ النِّكَاحِ فَهَذَا فِيهِ دَلِيلٌ مِنَ الشَّارِعِ يَدُلُّ عَلَى جَوَازِ وَحِلِّهِ The man to go through contract marriage so he can have an intimate relationship with a woman and to fulfill his desires, this means the Shari'ah permitted it. The Shari'ah permitted it. Sometimes it made it wajib. Sometimes it made it what? Mustahab. It gave it a warning. Sometimes it even made it haram. You see? It made it haram. So what does the Shari'ah do here? The Shari'ah is actually giving it a what? Hukum. So we take it back to whatever the Shari'ah made it. But إِذَا لَمْ يَرِدْ دَلِيلٌ يَخْتَصُّ تِلْكَ الْوَسِيلَةِ. But if there doesn't come an evidence for this wasila, there's no evidence for it. The Sharia hasn't given it wujub wala tahrim. What is the issue here? فَإِنَّ الْوَسَائِلَ عَلَى ثَلَاثَ أَنْوَعَ. Then the wasila is of three types. Are you with me? It's of three types. وَسَائِلُ الْمُفْضِيَةُ إِلَى الْمَقَاسِدِ قَطْعًا. Are you with me? Pay attention. A wasila that leads to the objective, clicker. It will lead to the objective that we're looking for. We know that this wasila is going directly to the objective without any buts or ifs. This one takes the hukum of the objectives bil ijma', unanimously agreed upon. And this is what the ulama of usuliyin use in other wordings, ma la yatimul wajib illa bihi fa huwa wajib. That's the one they use it for. Naam. Or they also say, مَا لَا يَتِمُ اجْتِنَابُ الْحَرَامِ إِلَّا بِاجْتِنَابِهِ فَوَ حَرَامٌ. They say. For example, what will be? A person wants to wash his legs. And he can't wash the legs, which we can't, unless we wash a bit of the shin with it. You can't really wash your legs unless the water goes a bit above the shin. So it becomes, you can't. So we say, فَيَكُونُ الْغَسْلُ ذَلِكَ الْجُزْءِ وَاجِبًا. It becomes what? It becomes wajib. And also within that one is, if that which مَا لَا يَتِمُّ لِاجْتِنَابُ الْحَرَامِ. It is, you are unable to stay away from this haram except by this wasila. You have to do this wasila in order to stay away from the haram. Then the wasila becomes what? It becomes something you have to, مَا لَا يَتِمُّ اجْتِنَابُ الْحَرَامِ إِلَّا بِاجْتِنَابِ فَوْحَرَامِ. You can't stay away from this objective, this haram, unless you stay away from this wasila. Then staying away from this wasila becomes something you have to stay away from. For example, فَإِذَا لَمْ يُمَكِّنْ اجْتِنَابُ الْمُحَرَّمِ إِلَّا بِاجْتِنَابِ الْأَمْرٍ آخَرْ كَانَ الْآخَرُ حَرَامًا. You can't stay away from this haram unless something else you have to do in order to stay away from that haram. An example for that is what? إِذَا اخْتَلَطَتْ الْأُخْتُ بِأَجْنَبِيَّةِ. If a sister, she mixes up with women, she mixes with them. Better one would be, example, my font here is, it's not clear. So the best thing would be, for example, a friend who you know that calls you to evil, and something you want, you can't stay away from this evil unless you stay away from this person. So it becomes obligatory for you to stay away from this friend and not hang around with him, because it's always going to be throwing you into this haram. Naam.